Hello friends, welcome to this video on lines and angles. In the previous video, we discussed the properties of lines parallel to the same line. Today we will solve some questions related to the same. Let's start with our first question. If a transversal intersects two lines such that the bisectors of a pair of corresponding angles are parallel, then prove that the two lines are parallel. Friends, let's draw a figure with the help of the statement. Transversal CD intersects line RQ and line TS at points A and B respectively. Ray AM is the bisector of angle RAB and ray BN is the bisector of angle TBD. According to the statement, ray AM and ray BN are parallel, and we have to prove that lines RQ and TS are parallel. Ray AM is the bisector of angle RAB. That is, we can write angle MAB like this. And similarly, we can write angle NBD like this. As ray BN is the bisector of angle TBD. Ray AM and ray BN are parallel and CD is a transversal. Here, using the corresponding angles axiom, we can say that angle MAB and angle NBD will be equal. If in equation 3, we substitute the values of equation 1 and 2, then we can write them like this. Now, angles RAB and TBD are equal. But these are corresponding angles made by transversal CD with lines RQ and TS, and they are equal. Therefore, using converse of the corresponding angles axiom, we can say that lines RQ and TS are parallel. Let's move to our next question. In the figure, line AB is parallel to line CD and line CD is parallel to line EF. If angle BPQ equals to 110 degree, then find the values of X and Y and then show that line AB, line CD and line EF are parallel to each other. We are given that line AB is parallel to line CD. Therefore, according to corresponding angles axiom, angle BPQ and angle DQR will be equal and the measure of angle BPQ is 110 degree. Therefore, angle DQR will also be 110 degree. That is, the value of X is found to be 110 degree. Line CD is parallel to line EF. According to corresponding angles axiom, angle DQR and angle FRN will be equal. And we saw that the measure of angle DQR is 110 degree. Therefore, the measure of angle FRN will also be 110 degree. That is, we can say that Y is equal to 110 degree. Note here, angle BPQ is equal to angle FRN. And these are corresponding angles. Therefore, keeping in mind the converse of corresponding angles axiom, we can also say that line AB and line EF are parallel to each other. We are given that line AB is parallel to line CD and line CD is parallel to line EF. Lines that are parallel to the same line are parallel to each other. We can use this theorem here as well and say that these lines are parallel to each other. Let's move ahead and see one more question. In the figure, if line XY and CS are parallel, angle XPT equals to 60 degrees and angle YPR equals to 60 degrees, then find the measure of angles A, B, M and N. Friends, look at the figure carefully. Angle XPT and angle PTR are alternate angles, so both of them will be equal. We are given that the measure of angle XPT is 60 degrees. So, the measure of angle PTR or angle A will also be 60 degrees. Angle XPT, angle TPR and angle YPR, the sum of these three angles is 180 degrees, as they are angles around a straight line. Here we know that the value of angle XPT and angle YPR. By solving in this way, we can find the value of B. Angle YPR and angle PRS are interior angles on the same side of the transversal, so they are supplementary angles. Therefore, their sum will be 180 degrees.
We know that the value of angle YPR is 60 degrees and angle PRS is M.
By writing in this way, we can find the value of M. We get M as 120 degrees. Look at the figure carefully. Angle QPY and angle PTR are corresponding angles. That is, angle A and N are corresponding angles. And the measure of A is 60 degrees. Therefore, N will also be 60 degrees. Friends, that's all in this session. Today we solved some questions related to properties of lines parallel to the same line. See you in the next video. Thank you.